Hi students, Olevels online present the video lecture series for adjustments for financial statements. In this video, we will discuss the provision for doubtful debts. This video series is helpful for those students who are appearing in Cambridge Olevels upcoming exams, either in June or November through CAIE or IGCSE for accounting, 7707 or 0452. Let's begin the lesson material. What are doubtful debts? A doubtful debt is a debtor that might become a bad debt at some point in the future. In this situation, let's see what the company should do. In this case, the company will create a contra asset account that is called provision for doubtful debts. It is the estimate of debt or percentage of debt that might be converted into bad debts. Before move forward, let's see what is contra asset account. Contra asset account offset the balance in another related asset account with which it is paired. In this case, provision for doubtful debts is the contra asset account which is paired with debtors. It is an estimate, that's why the company will not disturb the debtor account itself. So it will create contra asset as per the accounting conventions. Contra asset accounts also appeared in the balance sheet directly below their paired accounts. Why business needs provision for doubtful debts? Because they want to estimate the value of debtor that are might be converted into bad debts shortly. Secondly, to prepare the true and fair view of its financial statements. Let's have an example to understand the practical treatment of it. At 31st December 2018, the account receivable figure after deduction of bad debts was $20,000. It is estimated the 2% of debt, that is $400, will eventually prove to be bad debts, and it is decided to make a provision for these. Let's move forward, but we'll discuss the net debtor first. What is a net debtor? A net debtor is equal to debtors minus bad debts. This figure will appear in the balance sheet also. Let's check the recording entry. The recording entry for the provision of doubtful debt is profit and loss account debit by 400 and provision for doubtful debt credit by 400. This is the profit and loss account extract. The provision for doubtful debts will appear under the expense heading. This is the balance sheet extract. As per discussion, provision for doubtful debts account is the contra asset account. Will appear under its payer account, that is a debtor. This is the provision for doubtful debts account. We will create the provisions on the credit side by 400 and balance the account at the year end. In the profit and loss account extract, the 400 will appear from the credit side entry from the provision of doubtful debts account. In the balance sheet extract, the provision for doubtful debts account appear under the debtors with 400 value. And this value will come from the debit side of the account or CD balance of it. This is the accumulated figure. Now we have a case number 1. In this case, the value of debtor increased up to $22,000, but the provision percentage is still 2%. So the value would be 440 for the provision. Let's see the treatment of it in the account and financial statements. We have an opening balance in the account as 400 and the new provision for 2019 is 440. We will record the provision this year only by 40. This is the increasing value and will get a total provision, that is 440 at the year end. In the profit and loss account extract, the 40 will appear from the credit side entry from the provision for doubtful debts account. In the balance sheet extract, the provision for doubtful debts appear under the debtors with 440. And this value will come from the debit side of the account or CD balance of it. This is the accumulated figure. Now we have a case number 2. In this case, the value of debtors decreased up to $20,500, but the provision percentage is still 2%. So the value would be 410 for the provision. Let's see the treatment of it in the account and financial statements. We have an opening balance in the account as 440 and the new provision for 2020 is 410. We will decrease the provision this year only by 30 and should record on the debit side. This is the decreasing value and will get a total provision, that is 410 at the year end. In the profit and loss account extract, the 30 will appear from the debit side entry from the provision of doubtful debts account and it will add with gross profit. In the balance sheet extract, the provision for doubtful debts appear under the debtor with 410 value and this value will come from the debit side of the account or CD balance of it. This is the accumulated figure. Hopefully you got a clear understanding of the provision for doubtful debts and its treatment. If you have any query, kindly ask in the comment section of this video. You can download the related formats and lesson material through the link provided below. Thanks for watching. I hope you learned something new today. If you did, like and share video with other people to learn from it, and please subscribe to my channel if you want to see more video like this. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next lesson.